say yes to the Lord. We say yes to His will, yes to His way. Just tell the Lord yes from the inside. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yes. Yeah.
God your best praise. Amen. Yeah. Yeah. Yes, Lord. 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 Chapter number 2, verse number 13. I want to talk to you this morning, a continuation of what we began on last Sunday when we began to testify. How many know somebody ought to testify?
Yeah.
Greatest testimony you can give to God is to say yes. Yes to your will. Yes to your way. Philippians chapter 2 and verse number 13. The Bible says, for it is God. Everybody say, it is God. Which worketh in you. But there are two operatives that are working in you. He both to will and to do of his good pleasure. How many of you want God to have his way in your life?
Amen.
Yeah, just tell him, yes, Lord. How many of you want God's will to be done in your life? Just say yes to the Lord. Once you understand that you say yes to the Lord, you need to realize that along with that yes comes God's good pleasure. God wants you to say yes. God has given you the ability to say yes. That's why you got to fight beyond everything that's trying to tell you no. You got to fight beyond everybody that's trying to tell you not now. You got to fight beyond everything that's trying to tell you to wait. You got to fight beyond every challenge that's making you feel that the time is not right. If you know it's right for God to have his way, just say yes, Lord. If you know it's God's will for you right now, just say yes, Lord. Hallelujah. He brought you to this place for a time such as this. Hallelujah. When we look at the glory principle, that's what I want to talk to you this morning about. The glory principle. Everybody say the glory principle.
The glory principle.
You see, Paul writes, for it is God. I want you to know God is doing what he wants to be done in your life.
Yes, yes.
Amen. Everything that happened to me that was good, y'all help me preach, look over at somebody and say, God did it.
God did it.
Amen. Hallelujah. This pandemic, we've been, amen, transversing through for the last 2.5 years. I want you to know God is still in control. Amen. He uses the enemy. Hallelujah. One of my inspirational, devotional preachers that I listen to often tells a story, amen, about an old mother who was, amen, just barely making means and barely getting by. Hallelujah. And she was, amen, having a hard time meeting her grocery bill. But she believed that God will supply all of her needs according to his riches and glory. Anybody realize before you go to, amen, stop and shop, you should fall on your knees and thank God for him providing what you need. Come on, clap your hands and say yes, Lord. Amen, hallelujah. And so this older woman, hallelujah, her neighbor was a non-believer. Not only was a non-believer, he was, amen, one of the worst kind of non-believers. He picked at believers. He, amen, made mockery of the believers. And, amen, every time this older woman would begin to, amen, pray on her porch and call out to God, she would thank God, amen, for grocery. And he knew her financial condition, so the woman knew that she didn't have, but he was, amen, wondering why she would thank God for grocery when she don't have none. Amen. Are y'all listening on today? Hallelujah. While she was praying, amen, thanking God for grocery, he said, I'm going to do something. Amen. And so he went out and bought grocery. Amen. And then put it on her porch. And when she came out, she got there and she started thanking God for the grocery. Amen. That was provided. How many know God will make a way out of nowhere? Amen. The way the story goes, Sister Annette, hallelujah, that she started thanking God for the grocery that was on the porch. Amen. And he came from around the corner and said, aha, your God can provide that grocery. I provided the grocery. Hallelujah. And the woman just said, Lord, I thank you for providing the grocery and causing the devil to pay for it. How many know God know how to turn things around? Everything that happened to me that was good, y'all need to give God some praise and say, God did. But it was for my good. Even in my trials and my tribulation, the glory principle says, for it is God who works in you. Amen. He is both to will and to do his good pleasure. Amen. Once you understand God is working it out, you need to know that we are not alone in our efforts to serve God. How many know it's the will of the Lord for you to be here today? Anybody realize that it's the way that God brought you that you need to give him some glory and praise? Come on and say hallelujah. Amen. Last week when I left, amen, we had testimony. Amen. And I just tried to encourage everybody. Hallelujah. Because we believe in leading you in the path of righteousness. Amen. And little sister Kayla, as I could see her develop, amen, she acknowledged that she wanted to be baptized. Hallelujah. So I wasn't going to let this moment pass me by. Hallelujah. I know that her mother wants to be here. So her mother is saying to the daughter, hold up until, amen, I can be a witness. Amen. But I'm encouraged by the fact, amen, that if mama never makes it here, God know the heart of her daughter. Come on and say thank you, Jesus. And that's why you need to realize that God is moving. Amen. Every day that you wake up, you should expect God to do what he promised. Amen. If you want your children to be saved, look for God to save them every day. If you look for God to open up doors, look for him to open up doors over every day. If you're looking for your healing, don't wait till you get the doctor's report. You need to shout right now. You need to give God some praise.
God is remembering your
lives. And God is going to get the glory out of what you're going through. Somebody give up the prayer before he wins you over today. Come on and say hallelujah. Hallelujah. In what way does God work in us? Look at the name and say he's working it out. He's working it out to will. God helps us in our desire and motivation to do his will. Amen. When I woke up this morning, I woke up with my mind on Jesus. Is there anybody that didn't wake up in the same place that I woke up with it in? But you had the same mind. I mean, while I was here, amen, I had the mind that you had over there. And if we can just keep that same mind, amen, come on and thank God for that same mind. I had my mind on the will of God. Hallelujah. So it's not just being prepared with anointing myself on the outside. I begin to prepare myself on the inside. I said like the psalmist said, I will bless the Lord at all times. Y'all need to help me and sing his praise. Shall I continually be in my heart? Anybody got a heart that's going to make her boast in the Lord? The humble shall hear them up and be glad. Come on, help me make him larger today. Oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us. Come on and say, let us exalt his name together. Hallelujah. When I got the text from Brother Jones, amen, I was so thankful because the devil has been trying to stop him ever since the day that God gave him breath in his body. The devil been trying to hinder his progress. And y'all know the story. The deaf angel have walked in his house. But how many know, yeah, but I walked through the valley and the shadow of death. I come to tell you, Brother Shaheen, don't be afraid, because great is he that's in you than he that's in the world. Somebody thank God for what he's willing in this man's life. Somebody thank God for what he's working out in this man's life. Come on and give God some glory. Hallelujah. Praise God, God. He's working it out. Amen. To will. God helps our desire. What I'm saying to you, Brother Jones, keep on desiring. Amen. If you delight yourself in him, he will give you the desires of your heart. Well, I'm not just highlighting Brother Jones. Amen. But everybody that got a job, everybody that got joy in your job, everybody that got peace and joy in your job. So you think I'm talking about a paycheck? No, I'm talking about the joy of the Lord. How many know it's your everyday job to give God some praise? Let everything, if you got breath after these 2.5 years, if you still got breath in your body, you need to give God your best praise. You shouldn't let nobody take your praise away from you. And that I am empowered by the Holy Spirit. He's given me an assignment. I got to open up my mouth and give God some glory. Somebody that's on their job today, come on and give God some glory. Somebody that got joy in praising God. Amen. Look over at your neighbor and say, there's a glory principle in operation. Hallelujah. Now, when you understand God is doing it, amen. How many know he's doing it? Amen. Come on, help me preach today. Say, he's doing it. Amen. Believe it like you know he's doing it. Say, he's doing it. serves as the foundation for a system of belief or behavior, or for a chain of reasons. If anybody asks you, what's the matter with me? Amen. Tell them I'm shaved. I got a chain of reasoning. I got a fundamental truth. I realize that I'm shaved. You can't make me feel that God ain't gonna make a way for me. Because I know he can. And I know he will. Anybody gonna give God some reasonable praise? Come on and say hallelujah. When you understand this principle, you can say it like this. I beseech you, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your body as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God. And that's just your reasonable service. When you understand the power of reason, amen, I got a right and I got a reason to give God some glory. Have somebody understand your praise.
Oh,
wish I could get somebody to take your head this way and say, come on, go on, go on. Come on and say hallelujah. That's how I feel. I feel like the next 4 months that God has for us here are going to be powerful months. Is there anybody feel like that if you pass your way and then you're about to reach a place in God where you're going to see what you've never seen before? Y'all help me, please say, but the God of all grace, who have called us unto his eternal glory. I want to pause right now, and I want you to demonstratively let these two words roll off of your lips. And while you're letting them roll off of your lips, I want you to think about the goodness of God and just speak over your own life and say, eternal glory, eternal glory, eternal glory, eternal. Come on, look at yourself and say, eternal glory. And the hands that you got, the feet that God gave you, the mind that God gave you, the life that God gave you. It's not just for his glory yesterday. And not just for his glory today. But it's for his glory on tomorrow. Come on, somebody prophesy over your life and say, eternal glory. But the God of all grace, who have called us unto his eternal glory. How did he do it? By Christ Jesus. Amen. Everybody say, by Christ Jesus. That's when we look at the table and we see the blood that's there. We realize it was what that can wash away our shame. Somebody say, nothing but the blood of Jesus. You see, when you think about eternality and you think about it, a fact, amen, that we're going to infinity and beyond. You can't get there in your flesh and you can't get there in your blood. So when I see my hands, I see the eternal glory. Because he said, when I see the blood, when I see the blood, I pass over you. When I see myself the way he sees me, he sees me covered in his own blood. Somebody give God some praise for being covered in the blood. Come on and say glory, eternal glory. Well, when you realize that you got God's glory, when you realize that you're covered in his blood, you got to realize that just like Jesus suffered in the flesh, you got to arm yourself likewise. The Bible says, after that, ye have suffered. Look at your neighbor, say, just a little while longer. Amen. Y'all need to help me preach. Find another neighbor. That wasn't the best one. Find somebody else. I say, just a little while longer. Come on and say, hallelujah. They don't believe you're going to get out of this. They don't believe that things don't change for them. That I suffer a while. Ruel used that old song that sang something like this. I'm so satisfied. I'm satisfied with Jesus. Then they go to a point on the street and say, my soul is satisfied. How are you satisfied? I'm satisfied with Jesus. Some of them folk that were singing that song, they had broken sacks on their back. But they would say, I'm so satisfied. I'm satisfied with Jesus. They lived in a tent house. You wondering about how hot it is in here. Well, don't you know they had more heat? They had less covering, but they were still satisfied. Somebody need to give God some praise. Man, you could be in hell right now, but if you're not in hell, God has given you a chance to give him some praise. Open up your mouth and say, glory! I'm telling Jesus, I'm satisfied. 1 Peter 4:10. And every man have received the gift. Amen. Just wave your hand at somebody and say, I got the gift. Come on and say, hallelujah. Yeah, you better talk in confidence. Because you know you got it. But there was a time when you was afraid of it. Hallelujah. God would deal with you in dreams. He would deal with you in visions. He would give you premonitions. Hallelujah. He would help you get the numbers. Come on and say hallelujah. Amen. He would help you. Amen. Have a premonition. And you were doing the wrong thing. You said, why would God do that? Because the gifts and callings of God are without repentance. When God gives you a premonition, it's not just for the natural, but it's for the spiritual. But I'm so glad when I was immature and didn't understand how to operate with my gift. He looked beyond my fault. Somebody better be honest enough that realize that before you knew him, he knew you. He had his hands all around you. He took care of you. You did the wrong thing, but it was God. Somebody say, it's God. That's watching in me. It's God that's doing his good pleasure. He's both willing it. He's both doing it. Come on, clap your hands and say, glory. It's God both the will and the do of his good pleasure. I am so glad that I got God on my side. Somebody say, shake it up, Lord. Come on and tell him what you mean to tell him to shake it up, God. Hallelujah, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for me. My very soul cries out, hallelujah. Amen, I praise God for saving me. I want you to know it is God. And he's working it out right now. Somebody say, work it out, Lord. Look at your neighbor and say, work it out, God. Hallelujah. Once we understand who God is. Amen. I hope y'all understand what I'm trying to encourage. Amen. You see, God has strengthened you. God has settled you. God has brought you to a point that he wants to establish you. He wants to establish you in his own will and in his own way. Do y'all hear what I'm saying? Amen. The Bible says in 1 Peter 4:10, and every man, talk about the woman also, has received the gift. Amen. We got to learn how to operate in that gift. One more time, look at your neighbor and say, I got the gift. Come on and say, hallelujah. Well, what you going to do with that gift? It's by the manifold grace of God. When all of us that have been gifted by God begin to let God have his way with your gift. God didn't give you a gift just for you to put it on yourself and not bless nobody. But God gave me a gift so I can bless everybody around me. If you know you're gifted this morning, I want you to operate in the principle of giving God the glory and say, I am a blessing. Come on and give God some praise. Don't be a grace of God. Everybody say, man of hope. Hear what I'm saying straightway. Everybody, amen, who's not operating in their gifts, you're in danger of God taking it away from you and giving it to somebody else because it's too late in the evening. That's why I'm not worried about what I don't have, because I realize there's some folk that don't appreciate what they do have, and the wealth of the wicked and the lazy is laid up for the righteous. Somebody give God some praise for the overflow. I want you to believe God for overflow. I want somebody to believe God that you're not going to live just from check to check, but God is going to bless, and then your checking and your savings account, God is going to bless your checking, your savings, and your investment account. God is going to bless your checking, your savings, and your investment account. And if anybody thank God for a rainy day, come on and give God some glory. Give God some praise for a rainy day. And then you understand, Brother Watkins, I bless you up.
Hallelujah,
if you operate within the law, hallelujah, the devil cannot, amen, accuse. But I got the help I need. Hear me straightway. Hear what I'm saying. Watch what God does before this year ends out. Just watch what he's doing. It is God that's working in you. Both to will and to do his good pleasure. God is getting the glory out of you. Somebody give God some glory right now. For the glory that's coming out of you. The glory on your job. The glory in your home. The glory in your environment. The glory in your family. Yes, come. Let's give God the glory. God would never allow it if he didn't have this glory principle in place. Beverly always be concerned about big brother watching. Hallelujah. Your big brother be watching. He's watching so much, I say, huh?
Glory.
I pick up the rental car.
Yes,
you know, I'm going to charge my phone by sticking it in the USB port. Y'all know what I'm talking about. And because it's connected to the USB port, it's also connected to the meter that's in the car, the radio, XM, anything else, anything that's on my phone is now connected to that car. Y'all just walk with me a little bit and say the glory principle. Come on and say hallelujah. Somebody thank God for wisdom. Come on and say hallelujah. But what I did not understand is that it was connecting me with the vehicle. And so after I'm driving and I get to a point, I'm looking at the gauge in the car and I can see that before I get back to Hartford, I'm going to have to put some gas in the car. Amen. Come on and say hallelujah. But when I get up in the office and I begin to prepare the lesson for the day, I get a notification on my computer that let me know you need gas in that car. Come on and say hallelujah. It let me know right there, amen, that the car you about to get in, hallelujah, is low in fuel. Now that might seem encouraging to somebody else, but to me, I don't want nobody to have that much knowledge of what I need to do or what I don't need to do. It didn't tell me it was time for prayer. It didn't tell me that I should get up and read the scripture, but it was telling me I need fuel in my car. But the way I understand the principle, God was letting me know, don't run on empty. Give me help in my standing on your feet. It's time to praise the Lord. It's time to praise the Lord. Oh no. Don't wait too late. It's time to praise the Lord.
Right now.
Just encourage your neighbor to say, it's my time to praise him. It's my time. Hallelujah. I'm going to leave you with just six principles. Amen. I had a little technical difficulty. Amen. I wish I could put up on the screen, but it's not that way. Everybody just say with me, true satisfaction is in Christ.
True satisfaction is in Christ.
That's the first principle. Satisfaction is not in your money, it's not in your health, it's not in your friendship, it's not in your kinship, it's in Christ. Every head bowed right now. Hallelujah. Examine your satisfaction now. Are you satisfied with Jesus? I mean, be honest with yourself. Are you satisfied with the Lord right now? Hallelujah. 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 Ask him, say, Lord, help me be satisfied with you. Lord, help me be satisfied with you. Oh, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The second principle says there's no competition in glory. In other words, once you get satisfied, don't worry about who is and who not satisfied or what they have. And I thank God that God is only concerned about your satisfaction. Come on and say hallelujah. Come on and say glory, hallelujah!
Glory, hallelujah!
The third point says, don't die in seed form. This belief that you have right now is a seed. This satisfaction is a start. But don't die in the beginning. Don't die in seed form. You got to take that seed and plant it in the ground. I want everybody that got confidence in God, I want you to plant it in the ground right now. I want you to let it know you trust in him. Right now, I want you to turn it all over to him right now. If you're truly satisfied, if you're truly at a place where you give God the glory, come on, give it all over to him right now. Don't back in seed form. This seed is not your harvest. This is just the beginning of what God is doing. Hallelujah is just very simple. Glorify means releasing. I want everybody to lift your hands and just release it to the Lord. Just release it to him, right? Hallelujah. Put your hands down one more time. Put your hands to the Lord and just release it to him, right? Come on, put your hands down. And this time when you release it to the Lord, lift your hands up and say, Lord, I surrender all. All to thee I owe. Sin had left a guilty stain. Oh God, but you wash me. If you know you're clean right now, grab those clean hands and give God some praise. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Amen. The fifth principle, life is about dying empty. Don't hold nothing back. Yeah, yeah. Give it all to the Lord. See, once you release it, you got to give it to him. Yeah, and then the last point. We can't be lazy and see his glory. How many know you got to get up early? How many know you got to stay up late? How many realize it's going to take work in order to see what God is doing in this day? Every head bowed, all eyes closed. Father, in the name of Jesus. God, I thank you for your word. Lord, I thank you for reminding us of this glory principle that's in operation in our life. God, I thank you for enabling us to understand that you are both working in us, both to will and to do your good pleasure. Lord God, as we partake of this cup, oh God, bless it, sanctify it. Lord, use it for your will and your glory. Lord, as we eat of this bread, your flesh. Let us identify with your death and your suffering. And we're going to give you perpetual praise, glory. Now, God bless the gifts that we shall receive, the prayers that shall be dropped in the box. Yes. Oh, God, sanctify not only the gift and the giver. Use them for the upbuilding of your kingdom. And we're going to give you perpetual praise, glory, and honor. Everybody love the Lord, say in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Those that's going to sup with God, once you bring your gift, I'm going to ask that you will occupy the first two pews here. Amen. Hallelujah. After you bring your gift, you will just stay here. Everybody else, amen, once you bring your gift, you're free to go, or you can stay, amen, for the communion service. Follow the directions of the usher.
Chalice over, take the lid off of the
After the same manner, also Jesus took the cup and declared the cup of the New Testament of blood and given to the remission of sins. Drink ye all.
Thank you, Jesus.
For as often as ye eat of his bread, show forth the Lord's death and his suffering until he comes.
Hallelujah.
Anticipating his return until he comes. Thank you. As we may expect him from you in Jesus' name. The Bible says that they sung a hymn without to Mount Olive. We don't have amen, Mount Olive to go to. But we can greet one another still honoring. Amen, our protocol. Amen, greet one another as we depart in the name of Jesus. There's power, power, wonderful power in the blood. Liberal.